how the MOSFETs are designed, or how we use MOSFETs for designing a circuit by using computers, by using softwares. We will be dealing with that, how a MOSFET, that is a physical quantity, can be represented in terms of software, and we do the analysis of that MOSFET by using software, and then we go for further, like fabrication steps. Okay, so in this MOSFET model, we will see like how the models are generated, how we can use that models to have an analysis of a MOSFET. Okay, so basically the models, why the models requirement is there, what is the need of the models. So basically, for designing any circuit, there should be a model that describes the behavior of all the components that is available while we are going for designing our circuit. So here we can see, like, if we are going for designing a circuit, or suppose this is a circuit, so once we have made all the connections, okay, so whatever connections are there, so suppose there are different transistors and some connections are there, we have just made connections, and there should be an input terminal, and at the output we will be taking an output. So whatever connection we are considering, so suppose some circuit is there, so we can connect MOSFET. Okay, so we can connect a MOSFET, even capacitor we can connect, a resistor we can connect, and even the inductors. Okay, the inductors will be connected. So there are different components that we will be using, BJTs, okay, and diodes. There are different circuit components that we should be combining to get the desired or whatever response it is giving with respect to particular input. So what happens? So it is not like in the software we are just selecting MOSFET, and this MOSFET will be behaving as whatever desired MOSFET we are working on. So what happens, whatever MOSFET is there, each MOSFET is having a particular current equation. We all know, like, a MOSFET works in different regions, so based on different operating regions, and that different operating regions are defined by the gate voltage and drain voltage that we are applying to the terminals of the MOSFET. So how the MOSFETs are working, and in that current equation, okay, what are the different parameters that actually affect the current equations, we will be dealing with that also. Okay, so whatever different parameters are there, some parameters could be a constant value, okay, some may be a variable, like voltage, like VGS. So VGS is also a parameter that affects the current. Okay, and some constants are also there. So these constants are like mu, electron mobility and hole mobility. Even COX, oxide capacitance, is also there, that is a constant. Threshold voltage for a particular transistor is also a constant once the transistor is fabricated. So there are some different parameters that defines the relation with respect to the ID current. So how these parameter values, even the constant values and the variable values, will be taken or included while analyzing a circuit. So that information, whatever constant values are there, and what is the relation of these constant values with respect to ID, these are relations are given in the mathematical form while modeling a particular device. So once we have modeled, then that equations will be stored in that software. Okay, So the software that is used for circuit simulations are basically called EDA. EDA, or we call it EDA tools. Okay, so this is called electronic design automation tools. Okay, so this EDA tools will be required to design a circuit by using a software, and the properties of that MOSFET or any component will be defined by a model. Okay, the library, or you can say that this is model library, we call it. So this model, or we call it model files. Okay, so these are called model files. So these are a file that could be a text file. In that text file, whatever different parameters are there that directly or indirectly affects the MOSFET operation, all that parameters will be combined together, and that combined together parameters will be included in this file, and this file will be given as an input to these EDA tools. Okay, so these files, okay, will be given as an input file to these EDA tools, and based on the values inside that EDA tools, based on the values available on these model files, the EDA tool will be performing some mathematical operations, and that mathematical operations will be defining the ID current. Okay, so this is how simulation takes place while designing a circuit by using EDA tools. So we will be dealing with the to design any circuit, we will be dealing with the EDA tools. So there are different companies, electronic companies, that deals with EDA tools. Okay, so one of the top most company is Cadence. Okay, this is Cadence. Another one is Synopsys. Okay, another one is Silvaco. Another one is Mentor Graphics. Another is like Tanner. This is Tanner. So there are many more also, but one of the top companies that deals with the best EDA tools. Okay, so these EDA tools by Cadence, Synopsys, Silvaco, Mentor Graphics, and Tanner. These EDA tools are basically used to design a circuit, and in that circuit, what we do is we include model files of that circuit, and whatever connections we have made to that circuit with respect to that model file values will be called while simulating that circuit, and it will give output according to the connections and whatever voltages we have applied. Okay, so this will be dealing with the this complete analysis. Whatever this complete analysis we call it is given by this SPICE software. So this SPICE software, basically this modeling basically started in 1970s, okay, by the initial software that was called SPICE software. Okay, and it was defined by UC Berkeley University. So this Berkeley University designed this software in 1970s, and they built three models of MOSFET. Okay, so level 1, level 2, level 3 models. So these are the starting levels. So at that starting level, this SPICE software was developed by UC Berkeley to define the different models of MOSFET. So this SPICE stands for simulation program with we call it integrated circuit. This is integrated circuit. E stands for emphasis. Okay, so this is SPICE. So this SPICE software is simulation program with integrated circuit emphasis. So with respect to integrated circuit emphasis, we will be dealing with the simulation of the programs. Okay. Okay, so this is a SPICE software that will be dealing with your SPICE simulation. So basically the models, there are different levels of a model. So the first level started means, this is the first level, MOS 1. This is describing, describes a square law current voltage characteristics. That means, so whatever model or whatever equations we have studied in the first unit, like basic electrical characteristics of MOSFET, like how the biasing is being done and how the current equations are derived. So this analysis was done at level one. So in the level one, whatever analysis was considered was only the square law voltage, current voltage characteristic. In the level two, the analytical model, like how the models of MOSFET can be analyzed in analytical way with examples or with the, changing the values with respect to changing the values, whatever output is being done, based on that we will be deriving the mathematical equation, was done in level 2. So in level 3, semi-empirical model was done. So like some was mathematical analysis, some was the analytical analysis. So, okay. So both MOSFET, MOS model 1 or 2 and 3 include the second order effect. So in model 2 and model 3, second order effects was included, means we will be dealing with the short channel threshold voltage, threshold, sub-threshold conduction, scattering, limited velocity, okay, whatever scattering velocity is there, and velocity saturation, whatever velocity saturation we have taken consideration while what is the velocity saturation we have included also. So charge controlled capacitances. So these are the different physical processes or physical phenomena that do analyze exist in MOSFET is analyzed in model 2 and 3. These are included. So whatever this sub-threshold conduction is there, so to have a sub-threshold conduction, there will be some mathematical expressions, okay, some maths behind it. So these maths will be included for analysis of our particular circuit. So this analysis will be done while considering the software analysis, software simulation analysis, okay. So after that, we will have another model, that is BSIM 3 model. Okay, so BSIM 3 model is another one. This is a Berkeley University model, the same simulation model. So this is having more accurate characteristics, that is for sub-micron MOSFET models. Okay, so if MOSFET is operating in below, you can say 0.8 micrometer, if channel length is less than 0.8 micrometer, then that is considered as a submicron MOSFET. So to deal with submicron MOSFET, another model came that is called BCM3 model. Okay, BCM3 version of this MOSFET model. Currently the models that we use, or the currently the level that we use is for circuit analysis is level 54. Okay, so currently we use level 54 to analyze the circuit, the IC circuits with respect to the area tools. Okay, so this level from 1 to 2 to 3 up to 54. So what is the difference between these two? So what these all the models. So what happened? So initially the model 1 is there. Suppose current equation we have considered. So in that current, suppose we are considering saturation current. Okay, so suppose we are considering the saturation current or even the linear current. So in that, it will be mu n COX and W by L. Okay, this is 2 times VGS minus VT into VDS minus VDS divided by 2. Okay, so similar the expression will be there for so this will be the current equation. So in that, the parameters that we included is mu n COX we have included. So this is 1, this is 2, W and L, this is 3, and this is 4. Okay, and VGS we have included, so this is 5, and this is 6, and this is VDS, that is 7. So total 7 parameters we have included, or you can say 7 variables, like, okay, so 7 parameters are included at level 1. So whatever analysis we have done till now about MOSFETs, so whatever mathematical analysis we do actually, we consider only the level 1 models of the MOSFET. So as we go for the higher level analysis, or you can say more accurate analysis, we need to have consideration of different parameters that actually affects the MOSFET operation. Okay, so to simplify the analysis by hand calculation, what we do is we take only the level 1 parameters. But in reality, these are not only the 7 parameters that will be affecting the drain current. There are hundreds of parameters are there in actual MOSFET analysis that do affect the ID current, okay, or the device physics. So whatever MOSFET is there, so that device physics, their operations and their different phenomena, after including all the parameters, the more, you can say, large number of parameters are there to have this relation. So as we are starting with the level 1, we will be including the minimum number of parameters that can approximately define the MOSFET characteristic. So once we are switching from level 2 to level 2, the more number of parameters will be included. In the level 3, like it is written in MOSFET 2 and 3, these second order effects are being included. Okay, that means in level 1 there were no inclusion of second order effects were there. So whatever analysis we do actually, in that we never include the velocity saturation concept, charge control, capacitance, what is short channel, threshold voltage reduction, we also don't include while analyzing at level 1. So for mathematical analysis purposes, we only take level one parameters, but as we are moving deeper into the analysis, currently we use level 54 MOSFET models. That level 54 MOSFET models have more than 100 variables to define different operation of a MOSFET. Okay, so this is all about the MOSFET models. So we will start with the basic MOSFET model of, suppose an NMOS is there of level one. Okay, so how the structure of MOSFET and MOS can be represented in terms of level one MOSFET. So this is the model. So gate and drain, source and body terminals will be there. So it has included the capacitances, so different capacitances that will be there, and the RS, that is a resistance on the source side and the resistance at the drain side. This is the complete equivalent circuit while having a MOSFET connected to NMOSFET connected to load resistance and RS, that is resistance on the source side. And here the drain to body and source to body, there will be a reverse bias diode will be there. So this diode will be there. Okay, so along with diode, a capacitance will also be there between source and body, and similarly from drain to body, a capacitance will be there and a diode, reverse bias diode, is there. So this indicate the variable. So whatever this capacitance is there, these capacitances are of voltage dependent nature. Okay, so that's why it is a variable with respect to terminal voltages that we have applied. So this is the basic level one model. So once we go for level 54, okay, so once we go for level 54, instead of only these much of parameters, there will be lots of parameters that should be will be affecting the MOSFET operation. Okay. And that 54 model analysis can only be possible by using softwares. Okay, by using softwares. So we call it, so these softwares is called ADA tools. So that's why we need ADA tools to analyze MOS circuit. And also the advantage of using MOS this ADA tools is, so suppose instead of using ADA tools, if we are directly going for fabrication, and once we have fabricated the circuit and we go for testing, once we test it, we find like it was not meeting our requirement. So if it is not meeting our requirement, that means the whole process that we have done till fabrication and then testing all will go waste. Okay, so that's why we have to use EDA tools to analyze a particular circuit. And once after analysis, we have got our specification. Okay, so whatever specification we have initially considered, if we have got that specification, then we can go for fabrication. Okay, so that's why there is a requirement of EDA tools that do the analysis in a faster way and also are very much effective for designing an efficient circuit. So we have already seen these equations. So these are level one model equations. So once we have considered level one equation or level one MOSFET, so in that level one MOSFET, a linear region, in the linear region, the ID current will be given by K dash by 2 W L effective 2 VGS minus VT minus VDS square. Okay, and also a channel length modulation concept is being included. So even so, while analysis the MOSFET, we have only considered the channel length modulation in case of the saturation region, but in the linear region also there could be the channel length modulation effect. Okay, so in that also we need to include. So in the level one model, these are the linear current equations, saturation current equation, and the sub threshold voltage is given by this and this we have already seen, and L will be L effective. So this instead of L, we should be using L minus 2 LD. This is overlap length. So once we will be subtracting L minus 2 LD, will be providing you the overlap length. So that will be effective channel length. So effective channel length will be used. This is the level one. So whatever analysis we have done is even below that level one model of MOSFET. Okay, so these are the different parameters that are included into the MOSFET models. These are not only that much, you can see like how many parameters are included. So we can take an example. So suppose you can go for a website called PTM. This is PTM. This is predictive time models, PTM. This is PTM. So this PTM is basically predictive time models, technology models, sorry. So PTM is predictive technology models. So there you can download the models of a MOSFET. Okay, so here the model of a MOSFET can be downloaded. So the model is defined with respect to the technology. So like if technology is of 0.18 micrometer, and a technology is there of 0.09, that is 180 nanometer, and this is 90 nanometer. This is micrometer. It is not working fine. Okay, so with respect to different technology, the models will be different. So once MOSFET model is there for 180 nanometer technology, these values will be different for 0.18 micrometer. So similarly, these values will be required for designing the MOSFET, but for 0.09 micrometer technology, these parameters will be having a different value. Okay, that's why while analysis, before analysis of a circuit, what we do is we select the model technology, whatever technology we are going to be used for simulation, we have to select before going for simulation. So either you are selecting for 90 nanometer or 180 nanometer, you have to select from that, and all the parameters, whatever components we have used for that complete circuit, all the components will be having the same technology. Okay, either 180 nanometer or 90 nanometer. Okay, so this is our website. There you can get the PTM predictive technology models. So like this is PTM is a company that publishes the predictive models of MOSFET, or even MOSFET and FinFET. There are other technologies, TFET, JFET, अलग कई सारे अलग ट्रांजिस्टर्स के मॉडल्स हैं. इवन नैनो वायर्स आर देयर. सो देयर आर डिफरेंट मॉडल्स, डिफरेंट स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑफ मॉस्फेट, और इवन मॉस्फेट्स आर बीइंग चेंज्ड. सो ऑल द मॉडल्स यू कैन गेट फ्रॉम दिस वेबसाइट. यू कैन गेट द सैम्पल ऑल्सो, दैट हाउ मेनी पैरामीटर्स आर देयर इन दैट अ सिंगल मॉडल. ओके, सो दिस आर द लेवल वन इक्वेशंस. And this is how the variation of drain current with the model parameters are being varied. So this is a different drain current with model parameter like VT. This is with respect to threshold voltage. So how threshold voltage is being changing the current drain current. Similarly, this is transconductance parameter is being changed to how the current will be changing, oxide thickness and channel length modulus. So there are different parameters that will be affecting the current, the drain current are given. So we'll be moving to the next one, that is level 2 model equations. So in that level 2 model equations, so this will be the drain current. So this is ID. So this ID current equation will be having that much of length. So by the length of the equation, you can see like how many parameters are being used and what is the relation between the ID and all other parameters. So it is totally different than the level 1 equation. So that means once we are moving from level 1 to level higher, okay, the complexity of equation will be very much larger than the previous model. Okay, so this is the saturation voltage. If VD set is there, so how VD set voltage is defined, this is having that much of a relation. So this is how, so once we are going to use level 2 parameter, we cannot do the mathematical analysis by hand. Okay, so hand calculation is not possible. Okay, so once the hand calculation is not possible, we require the softwares to do these analysis, these calculations, and we will be just providing the relation, and with respect to input, they will be providing the output. Okay, so and what is the need to have a level, higher level? So this, once we go for higher level of a MOSFET model, that means whatever results we will be getting, that will be of more accuracy. Okay, so once we are going for using level 54 parameters that we currently use, the current simulation use 54 level model. So in that, more number of parameters defines the current equation. That means the chances of variation will be very less by using the software and by the complete physical verification. So whatever physically, if we are practically implementing the similar circuit on the chip, if we analyze that circuit after fabrication, that will be having a very less variation with respect to the simulated result and the experimental result. So these gap or these variations can be reduced by using the higher level of models, because higher level of models will be having more complexity, but it will be of more accuracy. It will provide an accuracy, better accuracy. Okay, so to have better accuracy, we need higher level of MOSFET models. So these are the different parameters that are used. So this KDES that is there, that is transconductance parameter, we can see like this KDES not only depends on the oxide COX and mu, and it is even also depending on the VGS and different other parameters. So these are gate to channel electric field, sorry, channel critical fields, and different other parameters. And some exponential fitting parameters are also used. So what happens once we are analysis, we are doing the analysis, and with respect to that, some practical values, practical curves that we are obtaining, and the mathematical curves, they are having some relation, some variation. So we use some mathematical fitting parameters. So some fitting parameters can be used to provide a similar relation. So this is how the other parameters affect the transconductance. Okay, the variation of channel length in saturation. So in saturation, the how variation of channel length is done. So in the previous one, in the analysis that we have done while analysis of the basic circuit in case of channel length modulation in saturation region, we were just used lambda is equals to this one, and we have taken like L dash was L minus delta L. We have taken this, and what we do we have done is we have taken L outside, and 1 minus delta L divided by L was considered, and this delta L, or you can say L, was depending only on the VDS we have considered. Okay, where there 1 plus lambda radius we have included a parameter, but this not only affecting this, this is having the relation with respect to that much of parameters. Okay, so these are the different parameters that should be affecting the channel length modulation in level 2 parameters, level 2 models. Okay. And similarly, the saturation of carrier velocity, so how saturation takes place while calculating the current in the saturation when the VD set has reached. So in the level 1 or the analysis that we have done, mathematical analysis of MOSFET, there are different assumptions. Okay, so some assumptions are there, so that assumptions with respect to the analysis, analytical analysis that we do, if that does not meet, then we go for some more complex analysis also. So this is the hypothesis that we have considered, like the channel charge near the drain current drain region becomes equals to zero. So while such VD set is there, means pinch off will be there at that time, the drain near the drain there will be no charge. Okay, that will be equals to zero and the device enters into saturation. But this was an assumption, but actually it is not correct. So since a minimum charge concentration that is greater than zero must exist in the channel due to the carriers that sustain the saturation current, and also the minimum concentration depends on the speed of the carrier. So whatever speed of the carriers are there, based on that the minimum number of concentration, how much charge will be remaining at the drain side, will depend on the speed of the carriers also. So speed of the carriers we have not included while analysis the channel length modulation in the saturation region. So these are the different analysis by equations that should be included while analyzing the saturation of velocity in that saturation or pitch of region or depleted channel region equations. Okay, and one more parameter that we have included, that is subthreshold conduction. So in that subthreshold conduction, there are different analyses, like this happens when VGS is less than VT. Okay. In that, there is a channel current even when the surface is not in strong inversion. So the current only flows when there is an inversion region is formed. But even if there is no inversion region, then also the current flows, and this current is called subthreshold current. And this is mainly due to diffusion between the channel and the gate region. So whatever channel and gate region will be there, so in between that, because of the diffusion, the current conduction will be there. Sorry, the diffusion, this will be because of the diffusion in the channel and whatever gate or drain or source terminals are there. So with respect to channel and your drain, because of the diffusion of charge carriers, the current will be conducted, and this will be considered as subthreshold current, and it increases as we are moving deeper into the lower channel length transistor. So once we are reducing the channel length, so the subthreshold conduction becomes more efficient, or you can say becomes more valuable, or it is having comparable value than in the linear or saturation region. So this increase in subthreshold region, subthreshold current, we need to have a better model that should analyze how the relation of subthreshold conduction is there with respect to different other parameters. The model implemented in SPICE introduces an exponential semi-empirical dependence of the drain current on the VGS in the weak inversion. So in weak inversion, that means we will be taking in the CV curve, like what is the weak inversion and strong inversion. So weak inversion means, so once VGS is equals to VT, so there the inversion has started, like inversion, we call it like channel has formed and current will be increasing. So then also at that time, the region is called weak inversion. So once the inversion is very less, So this inversion is called weak inversion. So in the weak inversion, the concept of current, the current will be this. Even the when VGS is greater than zero, if VGS is greater than zero and less than VT, will be considered as the weak inversion region. And beyond VT to some other value, it will be called a strong inversion. Okay. So in the weak inversion, the current weak inversion will be including the sub-threshold conduction also, because VGS is less than VT. So in that case, I on into e to the power VGS minus V on divided by NKT into Q. This is the total current that will be flowing in sub-threshold region. So there are different relations that we have not studied in the previous class, or can say Weyl analysis in the square law model analysis. So whatever analysis we have done or we do for MOSFET are called square law model. Okay. So level 3, we are increasing from lower level to higher level. More number of parameters will be considered, and it will be having a higher precision in terms of analysis of MOSFETs. So as we are moving to the higher MOSFET levels, the equations will be including more number of parameters. Okay, some other parameters like effects, short channel effects and narrow channel effects will be included. So these are the different models. So we will be finally discussing the state of the art model. So state of the art models means the best models that describe the MOSFET operations or MOSFET device physics very close to the actual device working. Okay, so these are the MOSFET models. These are called BSIM. So BSIM model that we have already seen. So BSIM, there are different levels of BSIM models also. So this BSIM model are called Barclay short channel IGFET model. So these are the models for IGFET that accurately define the device physics. The model is analytically simple and is based on a small number of parameters which are normally extracted from the experimental data. So whatever data, experimental data we have, we are doing, whether based on that we will be analytically considering some parameters to match the experimental data. Okay, and that parameters will be of a small number. So this model with respect to a small number of parameters will be providing a precise relation with the physical, or you can say experimental result and the simulator result. So accuracy and efficacy of this model is better, and it is widely used by many companies and silicon foundries. So different foundries use to prefer BSIM models because these are more accurate and more efficient. Another models are EKV models, Inge-Krumenecker. Okay, so Inge-Krumenecker KV Vitos model that we call, in short we call it EKV model. So it considers the strong inversion region and separately for weak inversion region. So this EKV model gives more focus on strong inversion. That is, strong inversion means VGS, your VG should be greater than VT. So we will see this in the next class. Okay, and attempt to solve this problem by using a unified view of transistor operation region and avoid the use of disjoint equations in strong and weak inversion. So it will be taking consideration of a single equation that should be depicting the weak and strong inversion operation of a MOSFET. So the gate oxide capacitances we have already known, studied, junction capacitances we have seen. So there are different comparison, like how the comparisons could be done between different models. So we have already gone through this also. So level 1 will not be a precise one. It is quick and rough estimation of the circuit performance without much accuracy at level 1. Level 2, it requires large time and may occasionally cause convergence problem in the Newton-Raphson algorithms used in SPICE. So in softwares, Newton-Raphson method is used for convergence. Once the convergence is there, then only the results will be shown, otherwise it will not be showing the result, it will show error. Convergence means the finite value should be there. There should not be an infinite loop to get the final value. Level 3, here the CPU time needed for the model equation is less and the number of iterations are significantly fewer for the level 3 model. So why iterations are less? Because more number of parameters are there. And disadvantage of this level 3 model is complexity of calculating some of its parameters. So as we are going to higher parameters, the circuit complexity will be, or you can say mathematical complexity will be high. So this is the disadvantage of level 3 parameters. Okay, so up to here these are the SPICE models, and now we will close for today. Okay.